Hello guys, welcome to this video tutorial. This is Sohail Abbasi from MeritPros. Let's get started.
Jenkins integration with a GitHub, right? Now, here we have seen, right? This is just a graphical representation. This is not the actual implementation. Now, this is the end result on my GitHub. How my project looks like on GitHub. Fine. Let me show you how things work. These are the things we have to take care of. First task is, let's say whatever the code I have here, right? This is my local machine, right? Any XYZ ID you can use to write your code. Right now I'm writing this particular piece of code, so that is fine. This is the code I'm going to write here. Let me just, now whatever the code I have this code only in my local machine. I have to transfer this code, migrate this code from here to GitHub, right? This is the first thing I have to do. Now, let me show you first and then I will tell you what is the complete way, what is the approach we should follow in order to send this code to my GitHub. First, let me check where my code is. It is in IDEA projects having Jenkins test. Okay, so this is the IDEA projects and Jenkins test, right? This is the code I have. Now, green signal, if you see here, right, this is the green tick. It means your code is already updated with the code you have in the Git repository. Red signal means your code is in your local machine but not in your GitHub. So first let me do one thing. Let me simply commit this code to my GitHub and then we will proceed further and we'll see. Latest commit for the date. The date is 21072021. This is the file where I have where I did some modification, right? How many lines added to and how many lines removed? 8. Fine. I'm going to commit and push the things together. Now the code is committed successfully. See, the code has been pushed successfully. It is success. I have to make sure, see, that this red signal turns green now, right? Icon turns into green. Let me go here and let me verify the same thing in my repository as well. Right now it shows 3 hours ago. Let me refresh it. And once I refresh it, it says just 41 seconds ago, right? So inside this, there is one file called main.java. It says 1 minute ago, you have committed this code. And if I come here, this is my, where is this file? Right, this is my main.java, right? So this is my main class. I have committed this particular, I pushed this particular file there. So that's how you generally transfer the code from your local machine to your Git repository. So the explanation, what I was doing, what I was explaining the things, right? First, we have to transfer our code from my local machine to my GitHub, right? So that's how we can see how things work, how things look alike, right? So this is my project. This is my project. Whatever the file I have on my local machine, the same files I have here also. This must be in a working condition. So remember one point, guys, whenever you try to commit any code in the repository, make sure the same code is working in your local machine first. Once you're very much sure that all right, your code is working in your local machine, then only you can commit this code here in the repository. All right. Otherwise, it will create so many issues to you. Right, guys?
Thank you for watching this video. Hope the covered topics will help you in your career development and growth. See you in our next video.